This lesson is solve two-step linear equations. It's the same as the last lesson that we did, except there's a step prior. You have to simplify to y equals mx plus b form. So the y, the m, and the b are real numbers. So it's a number equals a number times x plus a number. Our goal is the same as all the goals in solving equations. You want to obtain a variable equals a number. So x equals a negative number, x equals a fraction, m equals a decimal. Does not matter. You need a variable equals a number. So that's why we undo what is happening to the variable, because we want it alone. To reach the goal for this exercise, we need to simplify to y equals mx plus b first, then reverse the order of operations and inverse the operations. So first, simplify, use the distributive property, and or combine similar terms. And then we go back to what we learned before. We inverse operations in reverse order. The first one that we do is addition or subtraction. The inverse of addition is subtraction. The inverse of subtraction is addition. The second one that we do is multiplication or division. The inverse of multiplication is division. The inverse of division is multiplication. We are undoing what is happening to the variable. I had said before, always follow the rule. The rule actually doesn't start until you are inversing the operations. So when you're simplifying, you don't do to both sides. You only do to the side that you are simplifying. Our first example, solve for x. We have 4 times x minus 2 plus x equals 12. And I have distributive afterwards, because first I'm going to look at what side is the x's on. It's on the left-hand side. So that's the side that I'm going to work with. Since I have a number over here, that would be my y. I need to get this in the form of mx plus b, a number times x plus a number. So the first thing that I want to do is distribute this 4. Normally, you would have to simplify the parentheses first, but I can't subtract 2 from x. I don't know what x is. So I need to distribute the 4 to the x and the 4 to the negative 2. When I do that, I end up with 4x minus 8 plus x equals 12. Now my next step is that I still have 2 x's on this side. I don't just have one mx, okay, a number times x. I have 2. I have 4x and I have 1x. You should know that when it's not listed, the coefficient of the x is a 1, a positive 1, because this is a plus. So I want to combine my similar terms. So that means I'm combining 4x with x. 4x plus x is 5x. So I have 5x now minus 8 equals 12. Now it's in the form of y, which is 12, equals mx, m is 5, minus 8, where minus 8 is b. So I'm going to undo what is happening to the x. My x is on my left side. I have a subtraction of 8, and I do addition or subtraction first. So I'm going to undo the minus 8 by adding 8 to both sides. When I add 8 to both sides, I end up with 5x equals 20. To get rid of the multiplication by 5, I need to divide by 5. So I divide both sides of the equal sign by 5, and I end up with x equals 4. So my final answer is x equals 4. My second example, solve for x. I have negative 21 equals 1/2 times negative x plus 2 plus 3. So I'm going to look to see where my x's are, and it's on the right-hand side, and I need to simplify this into the form of mx plus b. To start, I have 1/2 outside the parentheses, so I'm going to distribute the 1/2 inside the parentheses by multiplying each term. When I do that distribution, I end up with negative 21 equals negative x over 2, and I have 2 over 2, which is 1, plus 3. Now I'm going to combine my similar terms. Combining my similar terms on this side is the plus 1 and the plus 3. So when I combine the similar terms, I have negative 21 equals negative x over 2 plus 4. Now it's in the form of y equals m is negative 1/2, x plus b is 4. I want to move that 4 to the other side, so this is where I'm undoing the operations. So I'm going to subtract 4 from both sides. I end up with negative 25 equals negative x over 2. I have a division by 2, so I want to multiply to get rid of the 2. And I want to multiply by a negative 2 so that I get a positive x on this side. I do that to both sides. So on my left-hand side, I have negative 2 times negative 25, which is 50. And this one, the 2's cancel. Negative times negative is positive, so I'm left with x. So my final answer is x equals 50. My last example, I have negative 15 plus 5 equals 3 times the quantity x minus 3 minus x plus 1. So on my right-hand side, I want to distribute the 3 to the x minus 3. So this 3 gets multiplied by the x, and the 3 gets multiplied by the negative 3. And I want to distribute this negative 1 here. When there's no number, it's a 1 that's being multiplied. And so negative 1 to the x and negative 1 to the positive 1. When I do the distribution, I have negative 15 plus 5 equals 3x minus 9. 3 times x, 3 times negative 3, 3x minus 9, and negative 1 gets distributed, so this is minus x minus 1. Now I want to combine my similar terms. My similar terms are the 3x is the similar term with the minus x. And then the minus 9 is a similar term, so I'm going to put two lines here to say that it's a similar term with the minus 1. Also combine my similar terms on this side, negative 15 plus 5. So I need three lines to say that it's on this side, and these are the two numbers that I'm combining. I'm not combining another number with them. Okay, so when I do that, I have negative 10 equals 2x, 3x, and minus x is 2x. Negative 9 minus 1 is negative 10. So now it's in the form of y equals mx plus b. I need to get rid of this minus 10 on this side, so I'm going to add 10 to both sides of the equation. That gives me 0 equals 2x. I need to get rid of the 2 times the x, so I'm going to divide both sides by 2, and 0 divided by 2 is 0. 2 divided by 0 is undefined. You can't have 0 on the bottom, but you can have it on top. It is 0. So 0 equals x. So my answer is x equals 0. In summary, first, you simplify by using the distributed property and or combine similar terms to the form of y equals mx plus b. Once you get it in that form, the second thing that you do is you undo what is happening to the x. So first, by addition or subtraction. To undo addition, you use subtraction. To undo subtraction, you use addition. Then, the final thing to get you to your final answer is you undo the multiplication or division. So if you have multiplication, you undo it by dividing. If you have division, you undo that by multiplying. What you do to one side, you do to the other side.